What's going on, y'all? Grind Motivate back in this thing again, man, with another video. And today I'm back on Thought Express with Brittany Renner once again.
Sir, can we get an interview? We're rolling loud. No?
What's up, rolling loud? I appreciate y'all. Good night.
We appreciate your pleasure. You know that, right?
Thank you.
Rolling loud, New York. Whoa. I love J. Cole. That was legendary.
Because this part of the interview actually flew under the radar for me, man. I didn't know that it happened, but it did, man. And it's basically Brittany Renner talking about some, I don't mind being trained up and trained out. And all that good stuff, man. So it, I guess, further digs a hole for her if you feel that kind of way. But before we get into the video, go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, do all three. You know, I'll be grateful. Do just one. Still be thankful, man. And go ahead and hit the notification button, man. Do all that good stuff. And share the video. Do something, man. Get me right. But yeah, let me know what you guys think about this whole situation down in the comments below, man. Do you think that it hurts her? Do you think that it helps her? What do you think about DJ Academics? Do you think he's lame as a fool? Because I actually do, man. You lame as hell running around here copyrighting folks and stuff. So I might not be able to show the video. We'll see. Lame ass basement academic. Yeah, I came out the basement. Nobody can, you can't copy off my answers. Lame. But yeah, let's go ahead and see, you know, what is she saying right here, man? Is it making sense, or is it like, shut the hell up again, Brittany? Let's go.
Yeah, but with other girls, like, if you look at any one of my niggas and you're like, yo, yeah,
my pussy is boring.
Let me ask you a question. So if your man said to you, yo, I ain't gonna lie, like, yo, my homie.
Let's just say if I had a man and he's like, us three, what's that?
You be done.
Yeah.
Like, take turns type shit or like all in the same time?
Or take turns. I feel like we've gotten really left field with this conversation, but I'm just telling you the truth. I'm not gonna lie. And Prince knows I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. But you know that.
Who's Prince?
Don't you guys want a loyal slip?
Yeah, but with other girls, like, if you look at any one of my niggas and you're like, yo, yeah,
your pussy is boring.
Let me ask you a question.
All right, man. So what did you guys think about what she said right there, man? She said she doesn't mind, man. If her homie wants to, well, not her homie, but if her boyfriend at the time doesn't mind bussing with another dude, she'll go ahead and allow it. And she'll allow it at the same time. Do you guys agree with that, man? Do you think it makes it look better? I think it's this further, you know, throws her into the thought realm, because it's like, how can you be questioning DJ Academics when he calls you the side chick of the century when you're saying shit like this? You are indeed the side chick, the fun girl. That's kind of fun girl activities, especially with two dudes. I could see one girl, I don't know. But I mean, I guess I ain't gonna say that, because it could be weird either way it goes, man. Threesomes. But I just think it's real thotty for a girl to get took down by two guys. I think so. Just my thoughts on it. Let's go to the next clip and see what is happening on that.
She
knows what he means by that, man. Talking about some, she's not burnt out. You know what he means, man. I think he means by burnt out, you are like side chick. You are a fun girl. You are not really worth anything besides a busting block or just a, you know, a consistent bus out. That's pretty much all you're worth. But let's keep going.
Look, here's the thing. But I would look at her as burnt out if she was like, yo, come join me and Quavo. Like, what do you,
that's lit.
Jello. First of all, I don't want to join no nigga. That's the reason.
But that's okay, nope. That's not for you. I'm just saying I'm never going to say that. I'm not going to sit on this couch and say never. That's all I'm saying. I'm never going to say never.
While you're single. Well, if you got a man.
No, if I had a man and my man was into that, like his dick got hard off the, you know, us doing that, why wouldn't I want to make him happy?
You, yo, stop it. So you, hold on. So you be cool with your man getting hard off you being with.
Getting dick. Taking dicks. Another. Yeah.
All right, man. So what did you guys think about that, man? I think that, that's the video right there. But I think that, you know, it's weird either way it goes, man. Especially if you got a dude running around here like, yeah, I want another guy to come in there and bust you out. Super cucked out. Lame as hell. weird, all of that kind of stuff, man. I'm just not with that one, man. I guess it is essentially weird on both sides. Even if a lady wants another lady to come in there and she want to lick on that thing and do all that kind of stuff. And I guess I got a question, man. Men, would you participate with another guy, man, in a bust out session? I'm pretty sure a lot of dudes probably already have, man. I always thought guys like that were kind of weird to me. It's just, yeah, I just can't be seeing nobody else or knowing somebody else bust right before me. That's weird. That's super weird. And if I did participate in that at all, I would have to bust first and then immediately leave afterwards. I'm not sticking around. That's weird. To sticking around and be like, oh, who did it better? Who did it better? That's weird as hell, man. And then, ladies, what do you think, man? Would you allow a double bust out by two guys? And I'm pretty sure all the ladies would say that. Like, yeah, what's wrong with that? What's wrong with that? We should be able to have a double bust out without it being called a train. I just don't feel like it's right. Like I said earlier, I feel like you get took down. If you got took down by two dudes, it's like, it's not the same as two ladies and a guy to me. Sorry. Just my thoughts, man. Ladies, would you allow another girl in the bedroom? If so, why? If not, why? But yeah, man, it's just another little video, man, to see what y'all thought about it, man. It definitely doesn't make Brittany Renner look any more of a woman to follow or model your young daughter after or anything like that. And it definitely doesn't make her into wifey material. I definitely wouldn't be stepdaddy for her. I don't think anybody should be out here playing stepdaddy for her. She's gonna essentially be the bussin' block of the industry from now on because she's submitted herself as that. And she already is kind of that because she's got like a thought list of people that she's been ran through by, so.
Playboy life of Brittany Renner, the greatest talent scout of her generation. She scrambled in the pocket with Colin Kaepernick, but had to cut ties after Fashion Nova couldn't support his political protest. She took a romantic trip to Rack City with Tyga, but the Young Money Marvel was overly dedicated to his OnlyFans. She romanced a big baller in Ben Simmons, but passed him off to Kendall Jenner once she saw his jumper was beyond repair. We thought her love with Lil Uzi Vert was eternal, but it's tough to stay committed when all of your friends are dead. She secured the certified lover boy himself in Drake, but father time is undefeated. She dated strip club Hall of Famer James Harden, but he—
You have that already. But anyway, man, if you watched up to this point, go ahead and let me know what you think about it. Like, comment, subscribe once again. Have a great day, and I'll see you next time.